of that. Come in same place, or just pick up where we left off.
Just come in same place. I'm to the dead, I'm not going.
Take it from the practice before the melody. Take it from the riffing before the melody.
Like I should hit open chords. Because when you choke down, it's just, I don't know.
Well, maybe don't choke.
Yeah, when I choke down with you, it sounds like too much.
I'm not choking at all. I'm he's Ramonesing it, man.
Hi, boys. It's Rocket. Seriously. Let's rock.
One, two.
That was pretty hot, man.
That was rocking.
Absolutely.
He's so transitioned to weird, yeah? Have you heard him, Mike, going to the solo, the first solo section once?
Going into the first solo,
like,
yeah.
From that grind into the solo, it seems shady to me.
Play the take. You know, those accents at the end of each verse, they get better. I'm not sure I've nailed them quite.
Good,
hey.
Can you hear the going?
Right?
Right. Going into that solo.
Is that comfortable?
Solo. Nice, man.
There's that one part in the middle that takes off even
the
more.
Riff with the vocal. Da, yeah. da, 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 da. It feels great, but I noticed that it's picked up before, but I never noticed it while someone was having to play.
And staring at them.
Man, that's cooking.
But just the it's that.
Yeah.
Making those audible, you know.
Okay.
Middle.
So that works. I like the sound we got on this one. Do need down. Fader levels. So this just goes off. That stays.
That's
correct.
All. Yeah.
Which of these faders are the same?
The stiletto 7 and 8. Those are pretty close. It's like -5, -14. Yeah, that's very, very close.
Okay. But I need the riffs in the middle too, yeah? But that's all right, but gotta let down.
Okay.
Let's talk about this part. So check this out, right? It's very, the very, very intro.
It's that first riff.
Mm-hmm.
This might be the first song on the record, right?
Yeah.
So in theory, this might be your first entrance on a Metallica record.
Make it count.
There it is, make it count.
Exactly.
No pressure.
Ha ha! Woo!
Just the first run.
Hi guy, play the one with Kurt Wright. No, don't please. Play 7.
The wow thing has not been recorded yet. It's still from the original. Just so you know.
I think the main questions are the guy coming out of the solo, the guy after each chorus. Whoa. It sounds like the first two are different than the last one. That sounds in the first, coming out of the first two choruses, they sound either too tight or too, what is it, too, are they high?
They're a different note than the last one.
Okay. Because the last one sounds right to me.
Last one's in D. These are all in E. It sounds good. You can have a big old vocal over that.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Come on, it's between the two of you guys. Come
when
on.
When I say ready, I don't mean if I hit record, will you play something? I know that's gonna happen. Something that we're gonna put on the record. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go! Second high note, more.
Yeah, see what happens.
Spunk on it.
Is what you're hearing is the B string is sounding a little bit. It's creeping in there a little bit. That's why it sounds the way it does. I'll try and do it again.
Yeah. There you go. Just like there you go.
It's almost like
get
a sweetie
that
thing.
Yeah.
That spike is where it starts.
Awesome.
No comping? Alright.
It's kind of comp. Here we go.
Metallica.
It definitely has the classic Metallica.
Classic Metallica, and also the intro.
Titles?
do a top yet.
Well, I prefer, you know, at the very end when he says, that was just your life.
Yes.
I think that's strong. I think it's a little more dramatic than...
Almost like your life.
Yeah. That was just, it's just right. Punchier and harder yeah, and more I, kind
I,
of...
I agree with that.
I like that was just your life. I mean, I would have thought maybe disconnect somehow, but that was just your life is much more evocative. That was just your life. Boom.
Hi, guy.
Yep.
Second half, we do that together, and I do some other vocal thing, okay. And then we hook up on the.
Yeah.
But if I play with them, they'll totally stand out.
You get a distortion kind of sound.
Running, and I did my steam and the whole thing.
It might not have been you. Okay. That's the thing. It's the total connection.
But today I didn't go running because I kind of slept late and I couldn't be bothered and I was still kind of in a pissy mood from yesterday, so I didn't go running
today. It's on fire today.
And then I come out here and it's great. For a man who believes in absolutes, it's...
What's the first spot that you have now?
For me, the... Just those coming in tight, you know, hearing it just like hit, you know.
Now the little gap there is good, but
yep.
Sounded really good.
Heavy and rocking.
That sounded like the best I've ever heard it, ever.
That's what I'm talking about, dude.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna do some punches.
Okay.
So, beginning of the... I know we just got a couple of these spots, but that was pretty far.
You know that part right there. Yeah, I didn't get the little...
Ready?
Yeah.
Sounds pretty... What's the riff? Okay. Try to have up as a track with this straight double.
Do we have a goose egg extra hang there if we want to do that?
Do we have a goose egg
there? Oh, sorry, hang? Do we have a hang on that side if we want to? Bow, wow, down, wow, ow.
We can, yeah. So here's the one, just Kirk's home solo.
Okay.
second one feels lively and feels like it's playing with the off the music. The first one feels like it's something that's composed and kind of labored over and kind of thought out. Sometimes when you have to kind of sit around and wait or whatever, you kind of get into the places where you overthink it. You know, but I think what we're going for here is so much more of a lively moment and something where we keep going back to the floor all the time, mm-hmm. and trying to make sure that that human element is there. And so the second one, it sounds like you're playing with the music and with the rest of us, where the first one sounds exactly like you're sitting in a room by yourself thinking and overthrobbing, you know.
Yeah.
And to me, it's really apparent.
I would agree with that.
19 day 2, 19 day 3.
No.
19 day 4. I mean, you know.
What?
Yeah, it's not bad, but I mean.
You're looking for.
No, I'm looking for ridiculous. Rick said this song was ridiculous, and I can't. It's not good enough.
But if you step away from the details.
It's just not.
This solo is not the only thing that's going to make anything ridiculous or come
every,
back.
Every nanosecond has to be ridiculous.
Okay.
Seriously, well, we got to set the bar a little higher, okay?
I'm with you. It's almost
so
like,
much more
impactful. Wow, what are we going to do? We're going to fill that gap up? It's cool, too, because you've got the strings on your guitar. Da, 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 da,
that should be the main push.
Hey, da, 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 da. So, I'll start from sort of the beginning of the break.
Yeah. Flat, huh?
Maybe try it at the end of the day.
Yeah.
What's on the menu for today?
Well, we've got.
This is one of the ones where it just feels like it should be that. I try purposely to go and find stuff in all the other songs where it's not the end of the chorus. But this one just fits.
You reach the end of the line. Is it the end of the line, or you've reached the end?
The end of the line.
New consequence machine. You burn through all your gasoline. Asylum over time. Never mind. You reach the end of the line.
That was the best one yet. Getting very close to what it could be.
Cool.
Something around the vocals because there's I can't think of a reason for it.
Eric, you're staying after school.
Yeah.
All the other kids are out in recess.
Yeah, I know. I'm on detention.
You have to go stand here on the spot.
That's the wireless sweet spot.
play in octaves or something?
Play that chord. You know the chord that you always play? That's what I'm playing. Isn't that what it is?
I don't know. I'll have to listen to it.
Do we know that's right, though?
That's what I've been playing.
That's what I play, okay. Too.
Alright.
Right on.
Roll. Come on, boys. 1, 2, 3, 4.
On the notes just before that, we're doing E.
Okay.
The other thing I noticed in that riff, you know, like a slide after it.
Try to set the note up again.
And the last one. To me.
4 and 5 are the ones we've been trying to get.
Okay.
So those are still funny. And then punch out and then grab the very last one. Yeah.
Last one.
Yeah, so check your E string.
All right.
That's good. Here we go.
I wouldn't mind hearing something that goes along with the bass to make it a little heavier. I don't know how you could make that part heavier. It's just, chord. I mean, he's doing do.
He's just playing. It.
It's one way to get into this noise. Instead of doing like. Yeah.
But if the kids aren't going to do it on their own, they're listening to it, that's the problem. That.
Yes.
So you're going down super low.
Yeah. Garlic.
I think everything going ba da da is not so great.
Okay.
Because the vocal and that guitar and that are doing it. The bass is at least doing a.
Check it out.
I'm thinking maybe instead if there was more movement, you know, like a. Da 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 da. You know? Something that moved around even more.
Why just for kicks? Just get one of those hors d'oeuvres, see what that does. And get an onion pakora. Crispy onion ball, deep fried in flour batter. That sounds just like having a piece of sashimi, huh? Say healthy. Well, we did the demo back in the day, and we did rhythm, and then
boo-doo-doo down the middle.
Okay.
There was no da-da-doom, da-da-doom, da-da-da-da in the front. So the issue of what note should sustain through that was not addressed. Maybe that's something James should be part of.
It's a pretty sophisticated musical question.
What's the matter with coming out then? What's the problem with coming out?
Sophisticated musical question.
What is the problem with this?
After 27 years, we're finally at a point in our career where we're standing in front of something sophisticated. That note.
Yeah.
Okay, so can that note sustain? Can that note sustain through?
No, because it's the same as this. See, it's all right during the first chord. Right there is a stretch, but right there is a low.
Well, so you just have to be out by that.
Yeah, basically.
Okay.
So how would you play it if you were just playing it? That's what you did out there, and it worked. So we're trying to get this the intro guitar. Boom, boom, yeah, little dude.
Oh yeah.
Well, the main thing is that's the teaser for the main
right, riff. Right, okay. Well, maybe you have a fresh perspective on it.
Wait. You know, that guitar starts four early. That could be cool.
Oh, dun 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 dun
dun dun. That starts over the intro. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One more, please. Got it.
Really cool if you can, that was a great thing at the end. If you can try and kind of end right where the snare roll ends. Daka, 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 out. Okay. You know what I mean? So what happens here? Is two rounds of that. Bana, wana, wana, banana, bana, wana, wana, banana.
Bass.
You've redone the bass in Black Squirrel.
Yes.
Should I slide with him?
I like that slide.
Try to play a little back.
Yeah, okay.
So everyone else is ready.
Okay.
And you're the anchor. Here we go.
That was good.
Yeah, I like that. Make you more strong!
This song takes my breath away. It's in different areas, certain vowels. I need to practice this a lot more. Maybe it's not ready to be sung. Well, there's a lot of singing over a long, stretched out period, especially, you know, the rise, fall, run again, rise, fall, black days, black nights. It's kind of, it's just long.
Dude, what's going on?
I got a new gig,
man. What's going on, man? I figured.
I'm vocalizing.
All right, I guess what James's aren't working out, man, and figured a couple.
There's a new kid in town.
Come on, there's a lot of songs. Like, I gotta let you sing one, right?
You know, yeah, we're each getting a song.
What don't... Okay, let's do it. I'm ready. What don't kill ya makes ya more strong. What don't kill ya makes ya more strong. What don't kill ya makes ya more strong.
The best up-tempo riff in the song is the one at the end. I mean, that it's so rare in our songs that the ending has a new vibe, and I love that. But maybe we have to bring it in earlier because it's so good.
Can we get a title out of this one?
Kirk? Wasn't it Scars on Scars?
All my song titles, I have gone for the most extreme, the most despair, the one that ties into that kind of thing. So I'd throw out Broken, Beaten, Scarred.
I just gotta maybe over-exaggerate opening it up.
Breaking your life, broken, beaten, scarred. But we die hard.
There's it. Yeah. That's weird. It's cool.
Little thing onto this, so.
Sound. You want to start?
What?
You want to start there? What's this
the
sound?
Murder scene.
Oh. These faders are all accurate?
Yes.
How about these switches?
No. I don't want to start with clean. I just thought
that
was a cool sound.
Yeah, no, no.
Sounding actually, huh? It's less that for some reason.
So let's put up Casper.
Alright.
Thought is that not gonna work. It's gonna mess with the flow of these. When we talked about the old stuff, the exciting rhythms, you couldn't have two things take the same place. So it's either you enjoyed the melody or you enjoyed the rhythm, and they kind of weren't able to live in the same place. So the melody usually suffered, which it got brought way down in the mix. And these melodies were written to carry the part.
Right.
So we need something to support it. I just want to put that out there to have that.
Continuity of everything we talk about every time we come to one of these forks in the road, which is like, let's go for the thing that sounds livelier. Mm-hmm. And to me, if it feels like it's, you know, Kirk is doing the solo, and then that was kind of how it was written. It was like he's doing the solo and then he goes in and starts doing that thing, and then when the rhythm turns into the low guy, he goes to the high guy. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not rocket science. It should be able to work.
It, like it belongs more with the chorus, right. You know, as an extension, which is okay. I just want it to be a unique sound.
Well, I'm kicking
try something with some character. And do we have a talk box? A couple ways you can do it. You can totally open your throat up, you know, and get it, or just keep the back of your throat closed and you kind of just do a tongue, right. You know. The tongue is a little less radical.
Right.
When you open your throat, it kind of gets.
Right. How's that feel?
It's cool, but, you know, maybe it's over the top. Maybe it's mixed. That's mixed way back. Maybe there's two guitars doing it.
Did anyone tell you that the love is the spit? It's a little shorter.
idea, James?
Well, I have The Day That Never Comes.
I like that.
That's great.
Pretty, I think, that's somewhat epic sounding, yep, like a song.
That's brilliant. Okay.
Along with our kind of, you know, the thing that should not be,
yep,
the kind of statement within the title.
The Day That Never Comes, like, that's really evocative.
It's pretty cool.
The day that never comes.
Really good at that, huh? It's all of this. Story.
Well, the technique is this.
Dude, you should do the intro. You can do this, go, you know, bow.
Yeah.
Bow. Gigs in jeopardy.
Oh no.
What's going on? He's a good flamenco, flamenco player. No, it's that bass player. Pieces of it are really good that can be repeated, you know.
Maybe you and I should just quit.
And have the temples. Yeah, that's cool. First of all, I have to say that what I call the Flight of the Bumblebee section, right before the verse comes in.
That's brilliant.
It's amazing. That's just a great, great section.
I don't know what part you're talking about.
The thing right before it starts to sing. Super fast.
Before the verse.
There's a famous classical violin piece called Flight of the Bumblebee, which is, you know, like 2 minutes long and like has more notes than anything ever played.
So let's hear 49.
Yes.
Okay, now, question for you.
Mm-hmm.
That fill,
mm-hmm,
the fill at the end of the second bar, creatively it's the same fill.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Put the fill in, And then we'll just have to see if there are any air cuts in there. Stop. That, that fill, or the best version of that fill should replace the skippy thing in chorus two. That fill has, the reason I'm saying that is it's played probably over the takes 6, 8, 10 times.
Okay. So what's
on? So that's basically what that is. It's half, it's a half length snare fill that lands on the and.
Okay.
So it doesn't land on the downbeat.
Yeah, and we talked about that. That's not a great part for me either in that song.
I think that part's great too. I just don't know if that's the best place for it in the song. I'm thinking maybe there's something else in the song that might serve it better. Where? I don't know.
I think what makes it so cool is the fact that it sits away from the guitar solo. But maybe that's just my own.
Yeah, that's why we had edited a version where it was part of the solo. Because to me, it does. It sounds like a send-off after the end of a solo.
Play it out from there.
Sure.
I'm cruising, man. I'm like, yeah, cool. Yeah, I can do this all day. Cool.
Whoa, man, you're crazy.
No, I want to rock it, man. I don't want to be playing those. Man, I want to rock.
Jugular, man. Cool.
I mean, that's well oiled right there.
Well oiled and greasy.
We are in much better shape than we were 3 weeks ago when we played this last.
I would say overall we're in just much better shape. I personally have lost about 4 pounds.
Do you think that should be big chords on each side?
Wow, wow.
The verse?
What's
I like this going along with the hi-hat.
What's the emphasis to you? What's the main guitar part?
Negative one. The vocal.
You want to come in with the lyric sheet and we'll go through everything?
All right. Yeah, I remember these verses were a little, like, where do you breathe?
That's as good.
Nope.
I don't think it flows as good. I think that other one flows better. What's to come and what's to be.
Okay.
Do you like it better jumpy with the extra stuff?
I don't know. The other one seems a lot like it's with the music too much, you know.
Yeah.
Still you run, what's to come, what's to be. Still you run, what is to come, what is to be. So, what I could do is I could just do some warm up vocally and see where I'm at.
Yeah, let's do that.
Jacob!
I would call the song Hunt You Down Without Mercy.
Hunt you down without mercy!
Hunt you down all nightmare long? Oh, those are, that's classic stuff.
Yeah! All nightmare long!
On that note, I'll say that my title is All Nightmare Long.
That's what I was thinking too.
I think that's just long. So great.
That's what I was thinking.
And it's such a clever twist on All Night Long. Yeah, all Nightmare Long.
It's a great line. That's a great line.
Syllable.
Remember we talked about emphasizing the open E instead of the high note. That's one thing. I don't know what we could do that, but... And then on the chord, yeah. But he goes...
He's pretty tight on that.
And it's like there's no low E on those chords.
Right.
And I think that has a cool push and pull thing.
And I know he was doing... I think a single note sounds pretty good on that.
Okay. Yeah, this is the track. Just come on, bearings. Go ahead and arm all four of those tracks. So you play the intro without a wah first?
I can.
Do we have a wah?
It'll be the volume on the other side.
All right then.
From the top?
What?
Sure.
Huh? Hey, listen, I don't need to hear nothing from the top.
I'd leave the pedal on and forget to turn it off. And
so let's let Zach, I'll do it. Zach's on. Let's try one more with me in it on.
Not bad.
That was better.
That was some cool.
Let's go for another one. We'll get comfortable with it.
Mm-hmm.
More cool. One really funky.
Yeah.
It's not dot dot dot. It's dot 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 dot.
Okay.
Yeah. It's S O.
And then,
almost
us. Almost us, yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Three.
I'm here, right?
Well, that's the bad one.
Okay, yeah, see, I was looking at that. Okay, I got you. I was like, I'm going to nail it this time. I got it on the screen, baby.
Variation of the bridge in the verse cycle, right?
It's kind of it's rhythmically it's the same as the.
I was thinking, you can't do if you did one track where it stayed the regular rhythm, that would just clash with all those notes, wouldn't it?
I don't think so. But it would just get at the end, have to figure something out. Yeah, if you want a single note rhythm under that, that would work. You hear that part again with just the drums and bass?
So there's no 2 and 3. This is a Pro Tools thing. I can't explain why. This goes 1, and then what you just heard was 4.
Let's do 2 then.
It won't let me. It went to 5.
Greg Finley, you're the master. This is the machine. He's the slave. You tell it what to do.
You want to give me 2 minutes?
No. 5?
I will do it, but.
Stay there. Just to see her longer on those fast, fast ripping thing.
Okay.
Please.
You ready?
Hell yeah.
Same thing again up there at the front. It was awesome. Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah, that too.
Word.
Say, is that rain or are they tears that stain your concrete face for years?
Is that about how loud you sing? We'll find out.
This part, yeah. Okay. It's peace at last, oh peace at last.
Let's try it.
It's peace at last, oh peace at last.
Give it that one, or you want to try it again?
Hello. I've been singing in a little while.
Yeah, baby. No warm-ups? Right in. For a minute there, I didn't put that you were reading your lyrics off your phone. I thought, he just got an email or something? He's reading an email? He's about ready to drop in?
Multitasking, dude. He's not focused, man. Yeah, I got all my lyrics in there.
On the phone?
Yeah. So I can sit and fiddle with lyrics on the plane, rewrite stuff.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm thinking about just doing one guitar in the middle, really razory, just going. Stems.
Oh.
Sir. That'll take a minute. You know how long that takes. Can you turn the Marshall and the crank on standby?
Yes, sir.
Everything else on. The crank can now come off a bustle. arm those guys, go to playlist one, go to the front of the section, play the notes here. Thank you, sir. You're done.
All right, we did it. 4 songs in 4 days. That's a decent week's worth.
Nice working with you, pal.
And dude, it was short. He too. We did a short day today. We did a short day on Tuesday.
Always a pleasure.
Always.
You know what I'm talking
about?
Always
a pressure.
song is really fun to play live because we've been jamming on it, and it's a song that will definitely, you know, in a live format, hold its own.
Yeah, I told James I think this should be, if we're gonna just play one new song this summer, I think this should be it because it's really fun to play. It's not, there's no math elements in it, you know. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like you just play it, you feel it, you don't have to overthink it. It's a great introduction to what's coming.
In a way, and not to taint what we got going on, but this reminds me of the solidity of the Black Album and the bounce of that. Uh-huh. It's solid. Mm-hmm. It's tight. But it's beyond the Black Album, for sure.
Israel! Into darkness fell! Why? It's really high!
Get Geddy Lee in here.
Israel, into darkness fell. You're just a funeral I've been waiting for. Rearview mirror.
You're singing great.
Uh-oh. It
sounds awesome.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, awesome.
All right.
Big power.
Huh.
Sounds like it's on.
Israel.
The whole concept around Azrael, which is... used to be the lyrics.
Which you took out, yeah.
Yeah.
I noticed that.
Which was the, you know, the angel that supposedly separates the soul from
right.
the body.
Body, yeah.
At that point, and, you know, wanting, somebody's wanting to speed up that process, you know. So, you know, being in love with the cemetery, hanging out in it, wanting just to end things and praying to Israel to come sooner. So Israel, he didn't sing quite so good as Suicide and Cyanide,
right.
You know. Israel, you know.
Right.
It ended up sounding like Israel or thing,
yeah.
You know.
And actually, Suicide Cyanide kind of makes the point even more specific, I think.
Really?
Yeah. Just a tad.
Singing suicide in the song, yeah.
But you see that, what I love about Suicide, I've Already Died, it's kind of like Hunt You Down Without Mercy.
Yeah.
It's like, it's
worse.
It's worse.
Hello, hello, hello. Yeah, it's getting better. Can you make it harder?
The only comment I'd like to sit here as we're, you know, getting so off on the song is that a month ago when we were down in Malibu, the phrase "let's just sack it right now" as we were struggling with the chorus and struggling with the arrangement came up from multiple people in the room. Okay, so my point with that is that to me this is a testament to the fact that all these songs are one step away from near greatness. It's just a matter of whether we want to work on them or not.
Trying to get the low end burn, I only got some low there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's played to me.
drums come in and start section. Maybe you should be here. Maybe I would start with that. Now that's you know, that's instant. It's instant. It just grabs you right away.
Yeah. But if this is the chorus, it could be kind of whatever it needs to be.
Right. For instance, in The Unforgiven, it still starts with a mellow part. And the intro
is the top of the song.
Yeah, so that could be the top of the song. Then we go to the heavy part for verse singing, and then we go back to it for chorus. You know?
What's the heavy part?
We were using The Unforgiven as the starting point because it swaps, you know, it's the heavy verse and the light chorus.
Albums, it's almost like an Angus Young kind of feel, you know?
What, this stuff?
In general, yeah.
Really?
To me, yeah. It's the sound, it's the attitude, it's the liveliness.
When I hear this stuff, I don't think Angus Young, but that's okay. He does.
Yeah, you know, that's just my observation.
That's the best feeling one from today.
I think that was really good. Let's just play it one more time and we'll move on.
That sounds like it might want to have a little more happening maybe earlier or double. It kind of ramps up at the very end, or maybe it should ramp up a little slower or a little sooner or something. And it's like if the volume swells, we're kind of sitting down the middle, and then ba 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 or something, like 1, 2, 3, 4 step up. But right now it's like the volume swells are the kind of the right side from the better part of it. And it sounds like it needs a little something that's a little weightier, a little earlier.
Okay.
Your entrance is just one.
Okay, I got it.
I forgot. It's been a long time.
A really big goose egg. Okay. Heavy metal. Ish. Because this is a whole vibe here.
It's really cool if you can. That was a great thing at the end. If you can try and kind of end right where the snare roll ends. Daka, 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 out.
Okay.
Pretty good. But 28's better, right?
I think so, yeah.
Let's hear 28.
On the choruses, I get really self-conscious, don't know how to end words, and I'm like out here tapping my foot, and I hear in my voice going, you know. Okay. By the light of golden treasure, how could he know this new dawn's light would change his life forever? How can I be lost if I've got nowhere to go?
I'm not leaving this song off the album.
It's really
got to be on the album.
I think it's a really, really great song.
If you don't put this on the album, it's a big mistake.
First of all, it's not us. It's
Unforgiven
you.
3. It ties the past. It's good. It's hooky.
It's super
hooky. It's going to grasp the fan that's hanging out in the middle, I think.
I'm totally with you all the way, bro.
And I always come back to this song. Maybe it's because I'm the singer. Maybe it's because I'm the melody guy. So I always come back.
And how can I blame you when it's me I can't forgive?
So what did you guys do yesterday?
Just listened to a lot of riffs and went through a bunch of CDs and tried to... I want to get through it so I haven't... I have an idea that, you know, there's an end point. It's like, here, this is where it ends. And now we have this much to work with. You know what I mean? So we're just going through, mapping out CDs and listening.
So I can't write any of this. It never ends.
They're already written. We've written the last riff there ever is to be written. I mean, you know what I mean? Just try and find, like,
hey, go through your
that
luggage.
Is just so good that you know. I mean, a couple, like, 3-4 things.
There's some good stuff on there, man. There's a cool thing on your Lucifer CD.
Yeah, there's a couple cool things on there, actually, yeah. I have to say. Well, there's 55 tracks.
Yeah.
I hope I can get one or two out of 55 ideas.
A few things on there.
It's always the digga diggas after the da da la.
Yeah.
Okay.
How'd that feel?
Okay. How are you playing this riff? Is that how you're playing it? Pretty much.
I think one is up and yeah. Are you doing a higher one? Render unto me, submit effectually, or submit, and there's only me.
This guy. Submit infectiously.
Just that one, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little soft shit.
It's gonna be a dance. Favorite, I can tell. It's gonna be the Judas Kiss dance craze.
What are you gonna do next?
What's the other one that's really different?
Well, gym bag.
Gym bag.
Gym bag. Gym bag. Yeah.
Chorus, it's like different, right? A different chorus. Yes.
Let's hear it.
Still in gym bag right now.
That's fine.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Let me just the rap.
Just the rap.
Yeah.
Did you solo? Can you solo it there? That sounds. That sounds like the lights in the wrong spot. You go get that mic.
Still. Way closer.
It's tall. I'm totally. I'm completely mystified.
Yeah. Why?
Because we worked for hours and couldn't even come close to these sounds.
We were going to commit. We were doing.
And it's like 8 minutes.
What
the sounds we're trying to get right now?
Yeah.
You're kidding me.
Just trying to match. Like, it was so far away. It was like,
with
James. Okay, I'm going to play my stuff. Okay.
Playing your guitar. And it was.
Bro, it's the long hair.
It's the long hair.
But I mean, that's like, I mean, we were not even close. We've been working on this for like half an hour now. And we're pretty much there.
I'm glad to know that.
You know what? I think
I'm
we
not
should
that
go.
Indispensable.
I think we should go home now.
Yeah.
We're gonna end on a high note. I'm not. I don't chance it.
But I'm just getting started.
Let's listen to the original one and figure exactly what it is we don't like about it.
What? It needs to be a higher note.
Let me see where the note is here. That's what it is, right?
Yeah. Well. It needs to be.
Can you go higher than that?
Okay, I'll do that. That sounded good too.
Yeah, that did.
That just made my past 3 weeks.
Excellent.
You don't know how retarded I was getting about that note.
Really?
Yeah, it's just, see, that's a whole other therapy session altogether.
Okay, I am.
Four things.
Let's hear them.
In the intro.
Yes.
You want to have some straight chords.
Dun, dun.
That are just straight.
Let's hear what's the bass doing. That kind of determines what the root is then. That's really. It's hard to explain, but. You know, they're kind of woven in there to where chords, I don't know if a straight chord would work.
Okay. It seems like it could be a little weightier. I don't know what you'd put back there, but maybe there's something that you'd put back there. When it goes to the harmony, I think the front of it, it's okay.
Down, down, down. You're not talking about that at all.
No.
Just talking about when, down, down, the single note.
When that comes in.
I mean, that part's pretty cool and unique. I mean, it could easily be taken to another level of the old days where you've got three-part harmonies doing it all, you know. Bang, down, down, down.
Well, originally I did it like that.
Okay.
But
when you're playing with your fingers, you're going. So, play that part with the pick. The fingers are going to be better.
Okay.
I think that was good.
That was good.
I need a little ear break. All right.
Turn pitch black when the fear abducts your tongue, when the fire's dead and gone. Up for one more?
I felt the metal.
Yeah. One more metal like that and we'll move on.
Okay. When the storm... When the storm has blacked... When the storm has blacked... Blacked.
When the storm has blacked your sky, evolution crucified. When the eagle strips your reign, assassinate the living flame.
The end of Fall for the Judas Kiss. I mean, trying to, you know, remember you said that, Rick, going along right with the music, da-na-na-na-na-na, was going to be more powerful. But trying to hit that better instead of trying to stagger it or, you know, wah-ba-ba-ba-ba-bow.
It comes to this, can I resist? Fall for the Judas Kiss!
This has got that epic feel to it, you know?
One of the things I love the most, to me it's one of the, actually the, one of the high points of the album, is James's part at the end of the verse, "So what now, where go I?"
Oh. That, absolutely.
That thing.
So what is, now? Yeah, we're going, yeah.
That's one of the highlights of the album for me. That's fantastic.
So what now? Yeah.
Title?
We both agree on the Judas Kiss.
Fall for the Judas Kiss! Yeah.
You want to play with the other guitar?
I want to listen to this in the track okay. And then see.
Yeah.
This, I think, this seems to be working really well in all the other stuff.
Livens it up.
Livens it up!
Ready?
Yeah.
You remember how this one goes? It's been a while.
Asking if, let's say we keep that thing that we call Cthulhu 2 as the main part of the song we're working on now, and we still want to do an instrumental, I just want to make sure that we at least know that if we put it in this song, that we have to do something else with the instrumental.
Well, I'd rather take those other pieces and put them in the instrumental, and then all of a sudden there's a breakdown that's total melody, you know? Like, goes to some picking thing.
Okay.
And then maybe, you know, then there's a harmony part to that, and that could be pretty good. I think that other part would work if something else happened, like if there was just accents or something. Drums.
Great. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, so there's no snare.
Okay. Oh, it loses the excitement.
For some DVD or something. Sorry. What would you like the drums to play during that part?
What do you feel, man?
Well, maybe that's to play it so I can feel it, because I can't play it if I can't feel it. So just play a little bit.
It should be like a. It should be like the thing in Bleeding Me. I can just hear that like that quickly. That's maybe the first two should just be you three of you guys, and maybe I'll accent the last two. You know the part in Bleeding Me at the end of the solo. Bow, wanna, now, bow, now, now, now.
that super banging.
I gotta say, that instrumental intimidates me, bros. I don't know where to start. I know it's the key of B. I just don't know where to start as far as learning it, man. I need a GPS for that thing.
Challenge.
I need a musical GPS because it's just, it's symphonic. It's a monster. It's totally intense. I love it.
Jam something. Why don't you guys play something?
That's heavy metal, right?
Yes.
Is that heavy metal? That's heavy metal.
One of the finest examples of heavy metal that you will ever hear today.
What's up, bro?
That picking thing?
That thing?
Yeah.
That's gonna be done on the solo thing.
Okay.
I've got a little piece of the bed kind of quiet in there just to put it on the chart for solo sound stuff.
Well, I think we're in good shape. You want to go up to the middle part?
It was cool rocking back and forth there. You get like a phasing.
It changes as you go back. Yeah.
It's really
sounds
in
awesome.
The pocket, this thing. I do think that what we want to do is we should. I think we got a great solo, and I really like the end. Maybe if you just wanna, can you chop the very ass that out.
That was pretty great.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be that loud. But it's great. It adds.
I think it's pretty good.
Let's get another take so we have another thing. On this one, when you end. Go to single note.
Yeah.
And kind of give it a little wall and get out. Hit the low note of the chord.
Gotcha.
That could be one of the best solos he's ever played.
Somewhere there was a wrong note.
I mean, was it a harmony note? Or was it a wrong note? Because not
the bass hit a wrong note.
Notes are always wrong. Sometimes they're relative. It could be a minor third to the root, a flatted fifth. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Your boys, James and them, were playing the B note. Remember when I told you guys about it? And you guys all came down on me. Oh, dude, this is a half step off. We'll fix it. We'll pitch change it and all that kind of stuff. Was it clack? Because they were hitting a B and I was hitting the B flat, which is supposed to be a B flat. That was a B flat. Did they hit a B flat?
Photo.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah. See, that would be the wrong note. This would be the wrong note.
Okay.
But I wrote that part, man, you know, it's like...
Is that your trip?
Calling
that's
me out on my part.
So let's try.
Man, yeah.
Whew. Shade off. How come you're crouching, man?
Oh, man, I just had to get low.
I hear you.
It's tough to know if that A is going to work in there, you know?
Yeah.
on my own, it sounds cool. Maybe because the bass is in there, or maybe just the way that note's hanging. I don't know.
Right.
The bass in right now?
The bass is in right now.
Can we hear that back without the bass? Like, I want it to be somewhat exciting, because that's pretty simple on that side.
Right.
Is it too fliddly fliddly?
I think it is, a little bit, yeah.
Sets it up. It's too much of a setup, you know?
Right.
I'll simplify it.
Okay. You want me to leave the bass out?
No.
That was the best one. That sounded like the record to me. It's made sense. I don't know what you were doing. I was really not trying to pay any attention to tuning or whatever you were doing. I just kind of was just listening. And nothing went, oh, that's weird. Are you hammering that?
First and third.
What if you hit all three of those? Would that make it clunkier?
I think a little bit.
You know what it has? It's, you know what that sounds like? It sounds sad. It
sounds sad.
And it sounds, there's an emotion in it. That sounds, it put chills. When I've heard this song, it always gives me chills on my back. It sends shivers down my spine. I like the idea a lot of having an instrumental. I think it's a total, you know, the rearview mirror of Orion and Live Die and Cthulhu. And I think it's a beautiful piece of music. I think it has a place on this record. Number one, it's incredibly epic. Number two, it's, quote, the breather. The way I envision the record, I have the song title as Suicide and Forgiveness, or Suicide and Redemption. So that's the song title. Turn that from the top.
Real, it's been nice.
Can't wait till he sings on 10, man.
It's gonna be awesome.
10 is a 10's song that will definitely round out the spectrum.
Visit some of the see what it sounds like.
So why don't I start it off? Let me just play this thing because it's kind of odd because it's something from his CD.
Back to the front.
Yeah,
that's a catchy line. I like it.
There's this
multiple it's gallops or...
Dave, you can do a lot with it. That's good, man. That's like old school aggressive. It's good. Let's go jam on that. We'd love to see if that would fit with the other one. The number 10 thing.
So take it from the double thing before the solo.
Killer.
I mean, that lends itself to all kinds of naughty, fun stuff.
Felt pretty good.
That's pretty fun.
It's making me sweat, so it must be something to it.
Sing over that, you can chorus over that, you can B part over it, you can move it around, you can take pieces of it to make B parts. I hear some, that's a good thing.
Like I said, bro, top 10.
Really fun.
As far as like arrangement, parts, intensity.
Oh yeah.
Economics.
Go get at it.
Rhythmic flow. Edge, aggression. Foul odor.
What about in that last verse, doing what you did, do you do that on the cymbal? Without the double kick, you know? Claustrophobic!
Got a lot of that.
Come out of this. Got, shabba, 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 shabba.
Got a lot of that.
Got that, okay. They're singing over this part. We're taking it from the top of that.
No, from the second one.
Okay.
From the second round. There's two and two, right?
Yeah.
Okay, from the second round.
Okay.
Take, I want to get that part, that little build thing, better. Get your fingers limber, you ready to go? You tell me when. That was hot, dude. Let me get a couple like that, that's the way to do it there. You notice where that spit it out? Have you been hearing that spit it out a lot lately today?
Spit it out.
Yeah, that was Lars' phone, right? What is up with that? I was like, no, it's not, right?
Totally. That's Lars's ring on his phone right now. Is this?
Spit it out!
Spit it out! Spit it out!
Yeah, what's
spit
that?
It out! I want something that's even more
flange. Eddie Van Halen flange.
Plug it in, dude. Give it to me. But I got this. Will go back and be clawing and flange, right?
That's right.
Come on, dude. What do you got? What do we got to lose, right? Check, make us do a stop on this next take. We gotta get that.
Spit it out! Spit it out!
What the hell?
It totally sounds like a car speeding off the bridge.
Even if that's just, I don't know, that's just fun. We'll see if we use it, but that was awesome.
Spit! Spit it out!
It looks like we've got three different things that we tried. I don't really know if one was better than any of the others, but... That's one thing we tried.
What's wrong with that? I mean, is there like a clashing thing, or... No, I mean, it's just, you don't like it, but there's not anything wrong with it.
It's following the bass. That particular three things. That's the one that follows the bass. But it's because is in that range. This guitar is an octave above the bass. And then, so here's this guy. Here's the bass. And the other two guitars are right here. And they're fighting in the same area. To me. To my area.
The melody
is hard
lower than normal. You know, it's up around this part. I'd say he gets a better, fatter bass. I mean, we got a good bass player. He could probably step it up with something there.
I hear something.
Yeah!
That'll be up on YouTube tonight at a...
Prophecy reveal, just magnetic, holding close the steel.
It's a burner, man.
It's only 450.
Yeah, but it's 300 miles an hour.
A lot of notes.
It's brrrr.
I think this one was the one that has the quickest consensus between James and me. I mean, both of us agreed that it should be called My Apocalypse.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
I agree.
Okay. Fine. That's just obvious.
Time to awaken my apocalypse. Need for the killers to man.
Good morning.
Next?
Good morning, Vietnam.
So this is that was great.
Yeah, next song.
How's the level at?
It's nice and loud.
Is it too loud? This
No, that's great.
Okay.